like a micro fix for this one specifically is because of how tough it was for her to come up out of that. I really think you gotta start working on this with her. I think you gotta start coming out of this hallway with her. Really slowly. So if the excitement is like as soon as she gets through this tunnel, because this visually to me is like a big funnel, like it's a lot of excitement and it explodes at the end, you know, like ah, like you run out of the tunnel, you're excited like before the game starts, you know. So this is what this looks like. So I'm sure she connects the idea of hurry up and get down through this thing because it's all, everything goes good at the end. And if it's excitement barking at her owner, she's got to learn. So I would get to the point that if she gets to the point where she's coming down and she's so excited, I turn around and I go back. Oh. So I would do this with this dog. I see how well she does this. When you stop, she sits. Come down the hallway with her. Starting tonight, when her parents come, when her owners come, will she be the only one coming up the hallway, or will there be, or will there be other ones?
No, we usually bring one dog up at a time.
So then I do. Then this is what I do. Like every time she starts to get excited, because she clearly can do it. Every time she starts to get too excited for you, stop. She's got to sit. And if she doesn't settle down, then we're going to start over. And this might take 10 minutes to get her to their room. That's why you can't be worrying about time. You're going to have to figure out. Because it might take 10 minutes the first time, but one thing I think people are not getting, they're not understanding, is, and I'm not saying you guys, but other people, one thing that people aren't understanding when I tell them something, they ask about how long, what should I do? And I'll tell them, I've got this one person right now that, how long am I going to have to go so slow on heel work? Forever is what I feel like telling them. And because they're, because here's the thing, if you do it, it's not forever. Like, you shouldn't have to put a dog on remote sit for hours on end. Eventually it just turns, it doesn't need to turn into a drill for that long. It just turns into habit eventually. Eventually, she lays down. But you know what? How long was she going to pace like she did last time? I don't know. But it wasn't going to be forever if I stay consistent with it. But what the problem I have is I've got this one person in mind. Wow. How long am I going to have to do this? I don't know. But the goal is that you do it long enough so that it has to be a lot less. And so you might have to bring her out and it might take 10 minutes. And if you think, we don't have 10 minutes to do this every day, hopefully it doesn't take 10 minutes every day. The idea is that it's going to be, you're just going to walk up, it's going to take 10 seconds. But it might take 10 minutes for the next 2 weeks. And then it might take 8 minutes for the next 2 weeks, and then 6 minutes. But by the time you get through this, and maybe those numbers don't mean anything. It could be a day, it could be 2 days, I don't know. I mean, we've had one day with her so far doing this, and day two, she's getting better at it. So I don't know how long it's gonna take. But if you take 10 minutes to get her up and it goes well, the goal will be tomorrow it's less than 10 minutes. And then the next day less than that, and the next, and then pretty soon it doesn't take as long. But I think, at some point, people have to dig their heels in and go, it's going to take as long as it takes. And I don't care what that is, because eventually it's not going to take extra time. So it's got to be the big picture, the end goal, it's going to save you time. And it's going to be a lot easier. But in the short run, that's why we're going to circle all the way back now to where we were standing there before, which I'll have you stand right here with her. Because now, we're just going to make her. But when we were talking before about, and look at the difference there. Like, we forced these dogs to not dictate that we want to do something. Like, show that one. I mean, it wasn't, well, we could look at the video when they walked up. It couldn't have been more than 7 minutes, I would say, since we brought the dogs up here. And that one was on two legs, pulling and circling. And then you had him to settle down pretty nice. And now it's laying down. And so, but I bet you, I wonder when the last time that dog was on a lead and just had to sit still for 7 minutes. But this is perfect example of they will. We just have to ask them to.